Hello again, everyone. Hello again. I hope that you are doing well. You can see I'm in the park. This is kind of funny when you are in the park like this. You see all the little kids, they come out of school. And you can see really the social class. So you see the little girl here and the two boys with the blue and this. You can see they are a traditional French family, religious. They have many kids, maybe four kids, you know, it's kind of funny. On the other side, you see this girl, you can see it's totally different. It's not the same social, very young. I'm not going to point at her too much, and she was cute, by the way. And not at all the same social class or positioning. And you can see here, it's a little bit under here, there's only one Muslim woman that you can see over there. And by the way, I'm all good with this kind of woman, you know. You see, sometimes I discuss with you and you see she wear the hijab, she wear the scarf. That's okay, I don't mind, you know. That's okay. You know what I mind is when people they wear the what's called the niqab, you know, they wear it all over the face. And look, you have all the small flowers here. And today I'm going, this smells good, I think. I don't remember, this is a laurier. Yeah, it's okay. It smells well. And that's fun. I was explaining the other day to my kid, you know, the flowers become fruit. And something that I want to discuss today, that's a very sensitive subject. I have one of my subscribers. Let me go around. I will come back after. And one of my subscribers, he was contacted me and we had we talked a little bit. I didn't have much time to talk with him. We talked a little bit. And then I was very happy to discuss with him because we have the same life experience. So this guy is also from Europe. And he has been watching my videos, and then he has the same life experience as me. So he has been in China many years, and he also, now I think he's not anymore, but anyway. And then we were discussing a little bit and about everything that I say, you know, and saying, okay, Chinese people have no empathy. Okay. Merci. Okay. She was, I don't know if she was holding the door for me or for a kid, but anyway. So you say, yeah, Chinese people have no empathy, you know. They are like, you know, you fall, you have a heart attack on the street, you fall down on the street, nobody is going to stop. Maybe there will be some exception, but people are very pragmatic. It's everything about myself. It's about everything, how can I survive? How can I survive? It's the survival instinct. And the only thing that you will care for is your group, the group. The community, not yourself, not the individual, the group. So the group is the network. The group is the means you need to have a strong network. In order to have a strong network, you need to have money. Money is part of the network. Because if you have money, you can. But money is not enough. Money is not the only thing. There's a lot of pride, you know. And anyway, so we're discussing about all this. And then for me, it has to do with culture. I always say it has to do with culture. But, and for him, I'm not sure, I don't agree with him, I don't agree with him on this, but for him, but that's an interesting aspect for him. It has to do, look at all the small flies, it has to do with the DNA, with the genetics. I'm not sure it has to do with the DNA, but he was telling me something, and that's quite interesting. You know, there are several kind of human beings, you know, there was Homo sapiens, and there was... What's the other one? Homo sapiens, and Neanderthal, you know, there was two kind of human beings before, and there were many other races, in fact. And we fought each other, and we killed each other, you know. There was different kind of monkeys, of human monkeys on Earth, you know. And Neanderthal was very strong, more individual, he was living stronger, and you know, and on the other side, there was Homo sapiens, and Homo sapiens killed Neanderthal. They killed the Neanderthal, and this was, they found out about this, 10 years ago. And they, in some place, you can see, they were even eating them. They would eat them, they would kill them and eat them, you know. And this guy was telling me, you see, Homo sapiens is Chinese. Chinese are Homo sapiens, more than us. And we have more DNA from Neanderthal. And maybe it's right. Maybe it has to do with DNA. You know, DNA genetics is what makes you, it's what defines your way of thinking. And that's always the big debate. And of course, it's taboo to say this. It's of course taboo to say this. Some people, they will say, genetics is everything, and genetics is what defines your way of thinking. Genetics is above everything. Genetics is above culture. Genetics define the behavior, the social behavior. And some other people, they will say, no, genetics is nothing. The only thing that matters is education. Education, and the education from the little age, from the young age, is this will define how you behave in society, your whole life. Personally, I believe more in education, you know. And by the way, that's the system of France. In France, we believe a lot in education. We said, okay, education can change any man, no matter where he comes from, no matter where, what's his skin color, no matter strong, small, intelligent, stupid. His genetics doesn't matter. His education matters, and the education will, and that's why every man is equal. And any man can achieve, so that's the thing. And this guy, he was telling me, and that's interesting. And honestly, this point of view is interesting, so I wanted to share it, you know. Let me take the thing, so I don't say it. You know, he was telling me, you know, wait, where is it? Yes. He was telling me Asian people and Chinese, they don't have so much testosterone, you know, and they don't behave like idiots. They don't have so much testosterone because their genetics is like this. And you see, and that's true when you are in China, women, and I told you this many times, and in Asia, women, men are not looking at women. They are not like, hello, woohoo. No, they don't even care. Seems they, you know, they don't care so much about sex, or it seems, you know, the testosterone is much lower, you know, it's much lower for sure, you know. And when you have less testosterone, it means your behavior is not the same, you know. So they don't think like idiots, you know. I mean, it seems very racist to say this, but yeah, maybe, you know. And that's true, that Chinese people, sometimes they behave like kids. They behave like kids. They are a little bit immature. They are not responsible, you know. They need to be watched. They need someone to tell them to do. You must do this. You must do that. This is bad. This is good. They cannot, like, decide by themselves. They are like, of course, you have in China, in the Chinese society, you have some people who are different, who act as leaders, but all the rest is just waiting, you know. And for me, it has to do with more with the culture, but maybe it has to do with the testosterone, maybe it has to do with the genetics, you know. And that's true. And because of the way of the genetics, people don't have the same emotions, you know. In China, maybe some of the emotion can be money, greed, possession, but in the West, some of the men emotion maybe can be love, sex, can be it's not money. In China, it's money. Why? And it's nothing new. It's not the communist system. It's thousands and thousands of years. It has been there a long time before. Some people blame the communism. I don't think it's the communism, you know. People want money. People feel safe with the money. So is this a system of, is it the culture or is it the consequence of the genetics, you know? So who knows? Yeah, that's what it is, you know. Empathy is not part of this genetics. Empathy is not part of the genetics, you know. And can you say that empathy is defined by genetics? That some people can feel empathy because of the genetics, or people cannot feel empathy because of the genetics? So everybody behave like kids, or behave like psychopath, or sociopath. You know, sociopath. I told you this. They have no feeling. It's not that psychopath. Psychopath is someone who is sick. You know, the society makes him sick. And sociopath is someone who is automatically is there. He's like this from the start. He's like this from the start, you see. Well, so it's kind of interesting point of view. So maybe this is the truth. Maybe this is the truth. That's, of course, it's taboo. And you know, everything that all the culture has been defined, even the religion, so from his point of view, all the culture and the religion is defined by the DNA, you know, is defined by our biology. I have no idea, but that's for sure that white people, black people, we behave in a certain way, and Asian people, it's very different. seems like they are not the same human being. And I told you this quite often. And I know it sounds racist and this is taboo to say this, but honestly, I told you quite often. And sometimes it's positive. You have people in the subway and they push, you're like, they will not get angry. In France, they will be like, hey, move out of the way, asshole. You know, they will be like fighting. People will be all crazy. In China, they're like, you know, is it because of the society? Is it because of the crowds? Is it because of the education? Or is there more to it? Is it because of the genetics? You know, before there was many people who would discuss this. But then there was the Holocaust. And then it was taboo to discuss this. You couldn't discuss genetics anymore, and you couldn't discuss sociology anymore. You had no right to discuss sociology. So all the videos that I'm doing, racist. What are you talking about? This is racist. Yeah. But no, it's not racist. It's the people behavior, it's the culture, it's the sociology. And maybe more than this, there is the genetics. I honestly don't like to think about genetics, and I don't believe so much in genetics. I think, why is that? Because as I was telling him, you see, there are many Chinese people who live in France or live in the US, and these guys, they are going to behave like a French guy because they were born here and that's the way they will behave. And even when they go back to China, it's difficult for them to integrate. It will take them a while, you know, it's very difficult for them. They lost it. They don't have the same, behavior anymore. But that's interesting. Maybe empathy is learned by the DNA. Maybe empathy is part of our DNA. That's interesting. Maybe some people, the biology creates them in the way that they lack empathy. And some people, the biology makes it that they have empathy, you know. And maybe that means at the top of everything you have biology, and then you have religion, and then you have, and that's how it is. And to him, it's always about survival, you know. He was telling me culture, religion, education, it comes after biology. Biology explains everything, you know. Maybe. Very interesting to discuss with him anyway. I think he will be watching the video, so I really it's very interesting. I really enjoy discussing this. Of course it's taboo, and of course it's a very controversial subject. Because I can tell you, even the mentality change, because today I can discuss this, and I'm sure in the comment section, maybe some of you will say, no, racist, but not many of you. And most of these guys who will say this, okay, they are Wumaos. But 5 years ago, if I were to do a video like this, maybe people would have attacked me, hundreds of people, you know. Today, that's okay. You can discuss it. So people are more open to this kind of thinking, which in a way, it's not so good, because it means maybe you will walk on the street and you say, low class, oh, low race, you know, or yes, over race, you know, or clever, you know, or stupid because of biology. And it's a bit dangerous to say this, you know. It's not, what else? And that's it. That's interesting. And I think the comparison with Homo sapiens and Neanderthal is interesting. You know, Neanderthal is very individualistic, and he was telling me, and that's true. If you are in China, Chinese people, they were never going to fight one-to-one. They will be like the group against you. And if you end up in the bad situation in China, you have 10 people coming to you and fighting you, and you will be one person, you know. And maybe that's biology. Maybe, in my opinion, it's not biology. In my opinion, it's because you are the foreigner, so you are not part of the group. And that's how it is. But maybe that's the biology of survival instinct. People group and they say, and they all come. And the mob instinct. Maybe the mob instinct means biology. We are, but this also exists. I don't think it's biology. I think it's more like we belong in the same class. We belong in the same world. You know, we are all the same. Because this will happen in many places, you know, in many places. If you are in France, people from the same social level, same category, they will team up together and they will help each other. It's more like this, in my opinion. Okay, à bientôt les amis. But that's for sure, maybe that's interesting perspective. And that's probably what happened to Neanderthal, you know, the poor Neanderthal, he was fighting against 10 Homo sapiens, but he, one-to-one, yeah, he could beat two Homo sapiens, or three Homo sapiens, he could kill them. But one Neanderthal versus 10 Homo sapiens, no chance, you know, no chance. Okay, let me leave you. À bientôt, les amis.